Ayushi Verma from Investor Learn Academy, and I welcome you all to this channel. In the last video, we understood how to read the annual reports. Today, we will look into another important topic of active versus passive investments. Now, let's start with the video. Active investment refers to a portfolio management strategy where the manager makes specific investments with the goal of outperforming an investment benchmark, index, or target return. It is also called as active management. It involves a much deeper analysis and the expertise to know when to enter into or out of a stock or any asset. A portfolio manager usually look at the qualitative and quantitative factors, then try to determine where and when that price will change. It requires confidence that whoever is investing in the portfolio will know exactly the right time to buy or sell. Now let's talk about some of the advantages of active investing. First, it helps in managing risk. Active investing allows money managers to adjust investors' portfolio to align with the prevailing market conditions. Second, investors can use active investing to take advantage of the short-term and long-term trading and investment opportunities. Traders and investors can use strategies to trade or invest in the market ranges or take advantage of the price momentum. Stock prices oscillate for majority of the time, which creates many short-term and long-term opportunities. Third, active investing allows money managers to meet the specific needs of their clients, such as providing diversification, retirement income, or a targeted investment return. Fourth, active managers aren't required to follow a specific index. They can buy those stocks they believe they have potential to grow upside. Fifth, active managers can also hedge their bets using various techniques such as short sale or put options, and they are able to exit specific stock or sectors when the risk become too big. Now let's talk about some of the disadvantages of active investing. First, it is very expensive. Fees is higher because of the transaction cost, salaries of the employees, etc., and all those fees can kill the returns. Second, it involves risk. Active managers are free to buy any investment they think would bring high returns, which is great when the analysts are right, but terrible when they are wrong. Now let's talk about the other type of investing, which is the passive investing. Passive investment is an investing strategy that tracks the market-weighted index or a portfolio. It is also known as passive management. This is the most common strategy on the equity market, where the index fund tracks the stock market index. The strategy requires a buy and hold mentality, as the passive investing goal is to build wealth gradually. Passive investing attempts to replicate the market performance by constructing a well-diversified portfolio of single stocks, which if done individually would require extensive research. Index fund, ETFs are the best passive investing ways available to an investor. Now let's talk about some of the advantages of passive investing. First, passive funds simply follow the index they use as their benchmark, so it has the ultra low fees. Second, there is a transparency, as it is always clear which stocks are a part of an index funds. Some of the disadvantages of passive investing are as follows. First, passive investment is very limited to a specific index or a predetermined set of investments, so it means the available choice of the funds is very limited. Second, passive funds will never beat the market, even during the times of turmoil, as their core holdings are locked in to track the market. Sometimes a passive fund may beat the market a little. Active managers, on the other hand, can bring bigger rewards, better rewards, although those rewards come with the greater risk as well. Now let's see the difference between the active investing and passive investing. Some of the points are as follows. First, the goal of the active investing is to beat the market index, whereas the goal of the passive investing is to get the market returns. Second, active investing is a hands-on approach with frequent buy and sell decisions, making most of the information flow and price fluctuations, whereas the passive investing is about researching, buying, and holding the investments. Third, active investing has higher transaction cost and research-related cost as compared to the passive investing. Fourth, active investing can also lead to higher capital gains taxation as compared to passive investing. Fifth, active investing carries high risk and potential to generate higher returns as compared to the passive investing. So I hope you understood the concept of active and passive investing. We'll meet you next week. Till then, happy learning and be safe.